could also do a combination tuck and slip stitch. The ribber is going to be for plain knitting, as we had in the beginning. Now the knitter, what you're going to do with one color, and I decided with the blue, the background color, I'm going to have my partial buttons put in. So now with the red, the contrasting color, I'm going to press my two tuck buttons in, knit two rows. I'm going to change the blue again, push in my two part buttons, and keep going for, and I'll do two sets of these too. Now this material, as well as the last one, is a little bit more stretchy. So if you need some stretch to your fabric that you're making an item, this would be a good one, or the last one would be a good one to try out. Again, you do need that elongated pattern where two rows are the same, because what happens is if you don't have it elongated, it's going to squish it. Now I did accidentally push two needles back, and I see some of mine are not knitting correctly. That's why I'm probably dropping some stitches. So once I change to the blue, now I can go ahead and push my plain button there and then push in my two partials, but just by pressing the two buttons, it ejects the other two. Notice it's the blue stitches, the blue yarn, that's not knitting correctly. So I probably should put some more weight on my cast-on comb. Oops. I don't know if the little one will help. Okay, so red is tough. Now, when my two yarns don't go in there correctly, the thing is, I'm not pushing my carriage all the way over to the left like I should be. So, blue's in, part. Well, I see some of the red stitches are not working properly, too. Going back and forth, remembering what color you had for the part buttons and what color you had for the tuck buttons. So if you're using just two colors, it works out a lot better. And here is the finished one of this combination. I think you could see how in the blue here it makes a little design, and it's actually raised a little bit. I don't know if you could actually make it out in the video, but I could see it here. And then the backing. Now I do see one row here, the stitches are really tight, but then the others are looser. So I probably had a little problem on that row there that I didn't realize, like with some other things I've done. But you still have the stripes. It just looks a little different because now you're doing the tuck and slip at the same time.